You're watching IEMG.
You're watching IEMG, and the next time that you go online, you get on YouTube, search Inland Empire Media Group, and when you find it, hit that subscribe button and the notification bell. We'll let you know the next time we go live with a game broadcast or upload the latest segment of your favorite show right here on IEMG. And welcome back to IEMG. It's our Fall League Champion Show. My name is Pep Fernandez. We're continuing our cross-country theme with not one, but two league champions from out of the San Andreas League, the boys and girls cross-country teams from Arroyo Valley High School. And Coach Limon, I don't remember this, but Coach Calderillo over here said that last year I said that the boys team needed to step their game up and get back on the couch. Here you guys are. Did I say that?
Yes. Yeah, yes. He reminded me that you said that. I said, okay, so here we are. Now we have both of us here.
Well, congratulations. We'll get Thank to the you. Girls team in a second. But as the coach of the boys team, we were talking off the air. You know, great senior, some up-and-comers as well. I mean, how would you kind of describe the blend of this year's runners on the boys team?
This year was very unique in the sense that I had one freshman, one sophomore, one junior, and then I had four seniors. So it was a very mixed blend. Usually it's mostly seniors or upperclassmen. So just seeing the transition of my freshmen and my sophomores learn from our team captain, which was Miguel, and just knowing that they have a legacy they need to leave behind now. And that's kind of the theme that was for them, like, what kind of legacy are you leaving behind at Arroyo Valley? And they kept pressuring themselves to unite as a team and just continue the work that they were doing. So I think that was a different type of take on this season as far as like their leadership and how they were. Nathaniel on the other side knows that he's the upcoming runner to now take lead of the team, so he was learning as much as he could from the captains, and so it was a unique season for sure.
So El Capitan over here, Miguel Antonio, if you could put it in your own words, what was that legacy that you left at Arroyo Valley for cross country?
Well, from freshman year, it was always a learning experience, and until junior year, I started taking more leadership. So by junior year, I started seeing, like, okay, this is how the program is running. And then I learned from my freshmen, from my captains, and then from sophomores, too. I learned from them, so pretty much I carried on what I learned from there into my junior year. And then senior year came on, and then, like you said, like, we lost the championship, but then my summer training, I told the guys, like, I won, because, like, this is the last year the San Andreas League will stand, so I want to leave a legacy. Like, as you said, like, leaving a legacy is always like a big thing. So I wanted to say, like, I want to leave a legacy by leaving the San Andreas League as a league champions. And then it was a good battle between all the competitors in the league, because everyone's really good. And at the end, we ended up coming up in top. And then that was like the legacy that all my boys have left. Like, so when you think of the last San Andreas League cross country champions, you're gonna think of Arroyo Valley.
You're right, because now they're kind of mixing the teams all up in this Arrowhead Conference. And I don't know if they've already unveiled what the leagues are going to look like for next year.
Not for cross-country officially, okay. Not that we know.
Yeah. Well, let's go to Nathaniel Gallardo over here. And Nathaniel, do you kind of embrace that challenge of continuing that legacy, whatever league you might be in, that, you know, Miguel and the other seniors have helped kind of shape for Arroyo Valley? You're next up.
Yes, I'm very excited to continue the legacy of continuing to keep winning league and always trying our best and making new bonds with the upcoming freshmen.
Yeah, because you said, well, you have one freshman, a sophomore,
a junior,
so,
and then,
so you got a couple coming back. I mean, it was senior heavy, but you got some runners coming back.
Yeah, and then we actually were very fortunate. We have a lot of incoming freshmen that will for sure be right there with varsity next year. So we're excited for the challenge.
Awesome. Okay, so that's the boys team. Let's go to the back row. Coach Calderilla, the girls also winning the San Andreas League championship. And how would you kind of size up the season that they had this year?
So coming back, so since we won league champs last year, that was the first in school history. So I wanted to make sure they weren't just like a one-time team to win. I wanted to make sure that they were able to stand on their own and go forward and win another championship. And that was what I was really pushing for them. So from the start of the summer, they were here at practice and they were ready to go. And after our first league meet, they were like, okay, we're in first. And then we were getting ready for our second league meet, and we had a couple injuries. We had a couple people who weren't prepared like we wanted them to be. And that second league meet, we pulled through. And then coming into league finals, we're like, okay, this is ours to lose, basically. And they put in the effort, they put in the work. With all the injuries and stuff, they were able to pull it off and win another league championship. So, I mean, going forward into the new conference, I'm pretty sure and pretty confident we can do another one, but we'll have to wait and see who we get.
All right, we got Paula Valdivia here, and maybe it was a battle to get through the season, whether it was injuries or maybe not performing as high as you guys wanted to be performing. How do you, when you look back at the season, how do you kind of see it unfolding, which ultimately ended in a league championship? So it was all good in the end, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we were definitely really proud of the girls because many of them would get injured, but they would still run through the races. They would still get through it because they wanted to do it for the whole team. Like Lucas at races, he would tell us, like, if you don't want to do it for yourself, do it for the team, because we all needed to push each other and just be our support system because we wanted to be back-to-back champions.
And Coach, let me ask you real quick. You got Catherine Labrada on the end. She's pretty good.
Yes.
Two-time SAL champion as a sophomore, so she's won out so far. What makes her a special runner?
You know, she's just dedicated. She's ready to go all the time. At practice, she's ready to perform. She doesn't want to be taken out. If she feels like there's an injury coming on, like, she wants to be able to run still. She doesn't want to be put, like, to the side and mm-hmm. rest. So I kind of have to talk her through that, and like, it's okay to relax sometimes. Your body, you're not superhuman. So she definitely tries to fight through the pain if she can and when she can. She's just, you know, ready to run. Like, I couldn't ask for anything better. She's just wanting to run every single day at practice, every single race. She's just prepared and ready to go. She doesn't want to back down from a challenge, and at invitationals, someone's in front of her, she's going to track them down as best she can. So, I mean, the next 2 years, we're going to see, and hopefully she can pull out another league champs.
So, Catherine, do you relax? do you just like to train and run and run?
Yeah, I try my best, but sometimes I don't want to, like, step down. And I want to not just do it for myself, but for my teammates. So I don't want to, like, step down and disappoint them. So I just try to give it my all. Mm-hmm.
The league championship from last year and the league from this year, different, similar? How would you kind of compare the two, maybe?
I think it was, like, different because last year we had girls up there in, like, top five. And then this year we had to, like, work through the team and see, okay, like, who's going to be our top girls. And some JVs came up to varsity, and then some girls that hadn't ran came up to be alternates. So it was different.
Coach Limon, let me go back to you. You told me some staggering stat. It was, what was it, like 9 years in a row you've had a league championship?
Yeah, so usually, yeah, we have about nine here and there, some taken away from us. But we've had about nine for our girls to be the league overall championship winner. So it's about 7-8 years of the same thing.
What do you think it is about Arroyo Valley Cross Country that you're able to produce individual and also team champions?
I think it's the fact that we really emphasize the family aspect, so that we do it not just for ourselves but for each other, and that we're in it together as a team. We're not just their coaches there to tell them what to do, but we ask them questions about their schoolwork. We hold them accountable. We just make them, and we're there for them and to be better people. And then I also think a big factor is that both Coach Caleria and myself are Arroyo Valley alumni. So we both graduated from there. We know what it's like. We know the teachers. We know the system. And so we can really relate to them as far as, like, how to help build their characters. Mm-hmm. And on an athlete perspective, but also I tell them, you're going to walk away being a better person from just this experience. So I think that sets us aside from, you know, other teams or other sports.
Congratulations.
Thank
Coach
Limon
Calderillo. We appreciate it, man.
Thank
you guys
you.
Are got a great thing going on the boys and girls sides for San Andreas League champion. So congratulations. We appreciate it.
Thank you very
Thank
much.
You.
All right, that's Arroyo Valley boys and girls cross country San Andreas League champions. We will have more right here on IEMG Fall League Champions. You're watching IEMG, and the next time that you go online, you get on YouTube, search Inland Empire Media Group, and when you find it, hit that subscribe button and the notification bell. We'll let you know the next time we go live with a game broadcast or upload the latest segment of your favorite show right here on IEMG.
You're watching IEMG.